Girls of Reddit, what is a big no-no in your book when a guy approaches you for conversation? The worst approach I've ever gotten was this guy that came up to me at a festival and asked if I wanted to see a neat trick. I said sure, and then he asked for my hand. He took it and put it directly on his crotch. I don't believe in hitting people, but I was quite intoxicated and so disgusted that I punched him in said crotch. Not sure how he was expecting that to end. Not being able to understand basic social cues. If I keep looking away slash at my phone and am giving you short answers, I'm not interested and leave me alone. Also, I personally don't like it when they say something about my appearance unless it's like, hey, I like your something specific. If they just come up to me and tell me I'm pretty, all of my internal alarms start going off. Seconding so many of the comments here, approaching and talking to a girl you don't know is fully dependent on context, and probably most of the time you should just refrain. Being approached by a stranger can be off-putting and threatening, even if you don't mean it to be, and it reinforces the idea that you aren't thinking about us, what we might want in this situation, like being left alone, and only about yourselves, which is something I'd hope you wouldn't want to do. If I'm minding my own business on my way somewhere, please do not interrupt me by making me stop and talk to you. If I have headphones in, or if I'm on my phone, it's often a defense mechanism to avoid being approached by men I do not know. If I'm alone, even if it's daytime, being approached can feel threatening, and that's not a good way to get on someone's good side. If you want to talk to a woman you don't know, first consider the context and see if it's appropriate. Think about what she would want, and don't just think about what you would want. If someone was approaching you, listen to all the women telling you that they don't like being approached by strangers. Now that being said, there are contexts in which it's okay to strike up a conversation. Are we at a social gathering slash space? Sure. Talk to me at the bar. Even in some non-social situations, it can be okay if the context is right. Seated next to each other on a plane? Try a friendly conversation. But most importantly, if I'm not interested or try to politely brush you off, take the hint. Don't be offended or moody about it. Don't call me a bitch. It's not a personal insult. If I'm not interested in you in this moment, you don't know me or my life, and it may have nothing to do with you. Be respectful of my choice to engage or not engage in conversation with you. If we do engage in conversation, try talking to me as if I were another dude slash a friend slash a human. You'd be shocked how many dudes start conversations with women as if they were some alien species slash magic sex dispensers and they need to punch in a certain code to get what they want to pop out. How do you chat to your friends? What interests you? Try that. If you treat me like the only reason we are talking is because you want something from me, odds are I won't be interested. If you treat me in the proper context, like you're interested in me as a person, which I hope you are, you don't have to be looking for a long-term romantic relationship to treat people decently like fellow humans, then we might hit it off. Again, be respectful, don't be obnoxious, don't be demanding of my attention, and treat me like a fellow human or a friend. Using some cute nickname right off the bat. If I don't know someone, it's weird as hell to be called things like angel, dollface, baby, princess, or unnecessary touching. But I don't like being touched by strangers in general. Leave the lady to initiate contact zones. She touches your hand, take it as an okay to touch her hand. Age difference counts. Might be that I find most people who approach me are twice or more than that my age. Gets more no-no if they start banging on about experience. I'm more likely to be more social with someone around my age and seems to have the same interests. Overall, it's down to luck and how we are feeling. If I've had bad week or creeped on earlier, most likely to be more defensive. Though if you want to be able to meet more women and for it not seem like no-no creeper, make more friends with women and go to more mixed social gatherings. Friend of a friend is less of a stranger and more likely to meet more people in a social event. Plus, if you have female friends, you're likely not to be a creeper. Any woman who has issues with a guy with female friends isn't someone you should date. If it occurs anywhere outside of a social setting where people go to meet other people. Yes, a bar or club or party. No, on the sidewalk, on the subway, on the bus, in the deli, at the grocery store, in a park, any scenario where I'm just trying to live my life. And if you absolutely must approach me in one of these places, if some of the first words out of your mouth are sweetheart, mammy, beautiful, sexy smile, or any comment about the way I look or my body, congratulations, you're awful. When you can tell a guy is specifically trying to get your attention before they say something, like looking at you lots, or even staring at your phone as you try to hide behind it. I feel bad for guys, honestly. It's hard to strike up a conversation, much less with someone you might find attractive. With that said, I also feel bad for girls. How do we end those awkward conversations without being that one bitch? Starting the conversation off with "I have a boyfriend" has only gone negatively for me. I'm a dude, not a girl, but here are my credentials. Have dated and slept with plenty of women, so what I'm about to say is not sour grapes. Have lots of women in my family around my age, so I hear what they say about this scenario quite often. Had plenty of long relationships, asterisk, so I also have heard many girlfriends' friends talk about this scenario as well. Yes, I'm old. Here is what I have to say. Just don't fucking approach women for conversation. Think about the dudes you know who are able to pick up women in bars. Are you one of these dudes? If not, there is no magic secret, no something you can say or not say in order to get women to go home with you if they already don't. There are some guys who, especially in their 20s and 30s, can pick up women in bars. Usually, it is because they are in the top 20% of attractive dudes, or else they have something else going for them. Many times, other guys assume that thing is confidence. That's just a feature of being able to pick up women in bars. Sometimes guys can be incredibly charming, or charismatic, or hilarious, without being really attractive. You can improve your charm and/or your attractiveness, and everyone probably should. But be honest with yourself, is it going to put you in the top percentiles of either/both? If not, stop torturing yourself. There are better ways to meet women. Trying to pick up a girl in a bar is one of the worst ways, unless you are one of those aforementioned people. If not, stop torturing yourself. There are better ways to meet women. Trying to pick up a girl in a bar is one of the worst ways, unless you are one of those aforementioned people. Look at the people around you who are in good relationships. How did they meet? The answer is almost never "he came up to me at a bar." Usually people meet through mutual friends and/or common activities. I know that part of the problem is that, in your 20s and 30s, you're probably spending a lot of time in bars. But maybe you are also in the wrong bars. If you are spending time in clubs or bars, where everyone is trying to pick up, and you're not in the top 20% of looks or charm, what the fuck are you doing? Is that fun? Watching other people meet women? Find some neighborhood pubs or more laid-back places, and you will likely meet more laid-back people, including women. Starting up conversations in friendly places is much easier. And those places are full of socially lubricating activities such as pool, or darts, or trivia, or karaoke, or whatever. There are women who hang out in these places, and they are cooler, emo, than people who hang out in fancy joints competing over looks. I did meet one girlfriend in a bar, but it was only because we were both bored off our asses, and happened to be sitting next to each other at the bar, randomly, bitching about how boring the pickup scene was there. Note, that's not a tactic to be too cool, or whatever, that's just to point out how random it was, and natural. Go out with the attitude, "I'm gonna have a great time getting shit-faced with my friends, and if I happen to meet someone, all the better." You will actually be more successful with that approach, not because you're like a woman hater now or anything, but because when that natural, random moment presents itself, you'll be ready, and already having fun, and you won't accidentally fall into the same stupid pickup lines when it actually matters. And that's how you meet women. Randomly and naturally. By all means, if you see a girl and you think for whatever reason that you two might hit it off, go approach her and say, "Hi, how's it going? I noticed you/I like your thing. That was the reason you thought you guys might hit it off. You are attractive does not suffice. Hey, hi, I love your t-shirt. Futurama is the best. Is way better than hi, my name is, blah. Can I buy you a drink?" Give her a reason to talk to you, because you have a reason to talk to her. If your only reason to talk to her as you think she's cute. She better be able to say the same thing about you. Otherwise, just save yourself the pain. Work on meeting the right girl. Be selective, as hard as it can be at that age. Don't crash and burn. It will wear you out. Don't go out with the attitude, "I'm gonna land me some pussy tonight," despite the fact that I'm zero for my last 20 Wii U. If I'm looking away, or looking at my phone, or looking uncomfortable, please just give me some space. I go for coffees all the time, and when people ask me if they can join me when there's other empty tables, I can't say no, but I want to say no. I just want a quiet coffee. Telling me to smile, "It's not that bad," or "You're too pretty to frown like that." Shut the fuck up. If you want to start a conversation and make me smile, don't start by telling me what to do and that I would look better a certain way. Invading personal space, touching, putting hand on the shoulder or waist, etc. You are not being charming and charismatic, you are just making the person in question really uncomfortable. Let her keep her personal space. This should be common sense, but somehow guys keep forgetting it. If a girl is at a place where she couldn't leave, i.e. bus stop, work, in line for something, don't start talking to her about anything above small talk. If I had a penny for every time I was held hostage with a conversation at work, I'd be working a living wage. If I just moved into the neighborhood and you wave at me through my window but never actually come over and introduce yourself for 7 months. If you decide to come over to the back door when we have a front door. If you decide it's a great time when my husband had just driven off. If I'm walking down the street with groceries, don't offer to inspect my bag then freak out when you find my new box of tampons. When I'm buying tampons or are in the feminine products aisle. When I'm buying underwear or in the underwear aisle. If I'm getting strangled by my card or by some assailant, don't just pop on over and chat me up, help damn it. These things have actually happened. Assuming I have no knowledge of whatever topic we are talking about, and explaining things I've known about for 15 years or more, particularly if we met at an edge event. I'm an entertainment writer who works the door at an alternative club, so a significant amount of our many neckbeard email patrons have the opportunity to educate me about bands I've been listening to for 10 years plus. Please, socially inept unkempt loser, tell me more about what's special about Metallica's first 4 albums. Standing too close, crowding around me, or in any way cutting off my avenues of escape. "I just wanted to say that you look really pretty and I'd like to get to know you better," is a fine statement, but it has a very different context when spoken by a dude standing 5 inches away from me, leaning over me like a collapsing building with both arms prisoning me to a wall. I will say a good experience I had was a couple weeks back. There was a sort of cute but dorky guy who came up next to me at the bar, a local pub. Someone else on this thread mentioned laid-back bars, and he's right, and he just said, "Hi, I don't want to bother you or anything, but my name's John. Would you mind if I bought your next drink?" At the time I was not single for 6 years and rarely was without my so, and I just sort of blurted, "Oh, I'm sorry, my boyfriend will be here soon." But his response to this, "Oh, that's totally cool. You still have a drink on me, and if you guys want to play pool, when he gets here let me know." Now that I'm single, I really wish I had played pool and gotten at least his Facebook, lol. I think this goes for all conversations, but help me with the conversation for God's sake. What I mean by this is, say things that allow for a response. Don't make me lead the conversation, it should be a back and forth. There should be a topic, not just a comment that you hope turns into something magically, i.e. "Stranger, hi, you're pretty." "Me, thanks. Now I have no place to go. I have nothing else to say." And the guy's just standing there expecting me to say something else. "You started this conversation, dude. You got to have something to go off of." What's better is something that allows for comment and expansion. If you don't know someone, it could be about the environment, it could be what they're drinking, it could be something that's happening. Basically, don't. Unless there is some specific reason that our lives overlap. "Hey, you are in my blah, blah class. Hey, I saw you at my cousin's wedding. If we really are complete and total strangers and the only reason you are approaching me is because you find me sexually appealing, just don't. Some women are probably fine with random strangers approaching them this way, but the vast majority I know are not. No matter how nice you are, at the end of the day, there is no hiding the simple fact that the only reason you bothered to talk to me is because you want to bone me. I could be crazy for all you know. The only exception I can think of is if I'm in a place that is understood to be a hookup spot, say a bar or nightclub. Do not fucking grab my arm or invade my personal space. I don't care if you just wanna talk or just wanna get to know me. You do not grab me out of nowhere like I'm a dog on a leash. Tap me on the shoulder. Or, hey, if you really want to talk to me, come find me later if it's too loud to get my attention, like in a bar. Jesus Christ, and the amount of guys that get offended when I tell them off for being rude or flip it back on them. How would you like it if some strange man just came up to you and fucking grabbed you like they knew you? Is staggering. I don't care who you are. I don't care what you look like, as I've heard men tell me that if he looked like Chris Hemsworth / Idris Elba / Godfrey Gao / William Levy, it'd be different. No, I guarantee you, it would not be. If you have never met me before, don't grab me. Yeesh.